Okay, as you can see, the carburetor is just weeping just a little bit. So I want to show you. I took it off the car, and if you look, if I can get it on camera, right here on the back side, there's a hole. Let's see if I can get it in the sunshine there. It's a little hole there, and that's a vent, so as the gas comes in, the air can be displaced out, but it'll also be, if the flow sticks or is adjusted wrong, the fuel will fill up and spill out over here. And also, and you can see down in there, it's kind of hard to see, the shiny part back there is the venturi, and then the two jets, the level of the jets are set to where they are supposed to be above the level of fuel. So if this fills up, and it'll spill out over the top of the jets also. So that's, if you got fuel dribbling out the choke throat here on the air inlet, it's probably coming up over those jets and flowing out here. And you can also have fuel just seeping down the back side here. And it'll be wet if, when you feel, you know, this is against the engine, so it's hard to actually see this, but it'll dribble down, and it'll, you can actually see how it's kind of made like a funnel on this Zenith. And it'll look like it's dripping off the plug down here, but you need to follow it up to the top of where it's coming out. So that's what is happening on this carburetor. And let's open it up. And see what it looks like inside. So if you take this large 9/16 head bolt off, this is the main bolt that holds the carburetor together. And depending on how long it's been stuck together, whether you can save your gasket or not. Release the gasket. There we go. Got a little bit of the gasket stuck down. Okay, now on this is where, you know, your drain plug is, but that's also where the main jet comes up. You see the main jet right here. Let me get up closer. The main jet right there, that's, you could see where once the fuel level gets above 5/8 of an inch below this line, and that's the spec you're supposed to use, is 5/8 below this line right here where the gasket surface is, where the two mate together. And you can see that would be very easy to just come through the carburetor, flow out, and it would flow out the input here. So that's, if you're getting gas coming out the air input, it's probably overflowing right there. So, and I actually have a little device here that measures 5/8, and you can see if I put that on top of the surface right here. Well, it's kind of hard to tell, but it should be that much below, and you don't have a whole lot of room with that jet. So let's continue on and check out the rest of this carburetor. You know, it's pretty close to, it's got a little bit of movement in the pin. If you can see that, it's like rocking just a little bit, where like, this is a brand new float I got just a few months ago, because they were on back order and it took forever to get. But this carburetor didn't have a float to start with. But the pin over here is so loose that, you know, what I'm probably going to do is check the thickness of this washer and probably look at putting a thicker washer in there, or make sure that the float is not bent up. It doesn't look bad. I think the problem is this right here. See how large the hole on the float is, and this pin? You know, it's very loose. You know, you don't want it tight so it'll move, but you know, I don't know where this float was made. You know, they may not realize it. You know, the soldering on it's not very good either. So hopefully it'll float. Let's see. I think it's 5/8. Yeah. You know, it's also a new float, so shouldn't have a problem with it. You see, when you buy some of these kits, they come with these little rectangle cardboard pieces. What that's for is when you're measuring your fuel level, this is 5/8 width this way. So using one of these tools I just had a second ago, there it is. When you screw this down below here, your fuel level should come up in the tube to this bottom right here. So that's what this little piece of cardboard in some of the kits have. I don't really want to bend the float itself. So the kit should come with 3 smaller washers, which go on some of the jets, and a medium-sized washer, and then you have these 2 larger washers. Just checking to see if they're the same thickness or not. I think in this kit they're just the same thickness because there's nothing written on them identifying the differences. But I think I'm going to just go ahead and add another one because I know I have a problem. And then I'll try to measure it and see where it comes out. I took the carburetor off and took it outside and let it emptied the fuel out of it and let it air out for a while. And when you're putting the pin back in, one side has a little grip that holds it and squeezes it. So it's a little hard to force through on that side. And now it's looking a little high. But I don't know that I'm going to be running it hard enough to run the bowl out of fuel. So this isn't high performance engine. So I think we're good. And at least it shouldn't leak. And we'll get to testing the level. And put the bolt back through. There it goes. Sixteenth wrench. All right, so now let's set it up for checking the fuel level. Okay, now I'm gonna hook up this device. There's several different makes of these, and this one I bought from Mike's Affordable. It's just a fitting with the gasket, a rubber tube, and then this little wire actually holds the tube so that it'll stay upright like that. And so you have to have the wire in there. But the first thing you would do is take the plug out. It's a half inch wrench. I had already loosened it, so it's not very tight. And then you take this apart, so you take the tube off. This is a little bit different than some of them that are a bent metal tube. Just whatever your preference is. They both work the same. This one just is a little easier to use, you know, when it's on the car. Because you can bend the wire in the tube however you want. So what you need to do is not crimp it down here so it blocks the fuel flow, but still have it to where it'll flow. And what you're going to look for is at the mating surface right there. So it should come down. Okay, I'm just going to put a little mark on the tube just to make it easier. So we should be good to go and hook it back up and run some fuel in it. you got to remember, once you do that, you'll have to use a catch basin to catch the fuel once you take this back off, because you don't leave this on there. Then you put your plug back on. So let's go mount it back up on the car. Okay, since I don't have the fenders on here, this one is a little easier to see. And since I had the carburetor off, I don't, you know, if we get bugs or something caught up in there, I just use the rubber glove to seal it off. And I left my bolts in there, so should be ready to mount it back up here. I'm using a temporary gas tank, so I have to remount it up here. Okay, so I got the gas shut off right now, and I put this towel in here just to be able to see the fuel a little easier if we can see it. Okay, releasing the fuel. And you can see it went to about where my white line was, which is right there. Right there. So it's pretty much right on the money. I don't know if you'll be able to pick it up in the on the camera. So you can see this is a 5/8 measuring device, so it's right there where the fuel level is, so should be better and not have any overflow problems now. So now I gotta take this back off and put the plug back in.